Well, Edie, for the first time since Jaycee Dugard's return, one of her family members was speaking out today. Meanwhile, police talked today about another case which may be connected to Jaycee's alleged abductor. KCRA3's David Bienick begins our team coverage. David.
Galston, good evening. For now, Jaycee's family says it is all about playing video games, watching movies, and reconnecting.
Tina Dugard says 1 week ago, when she first saw her niece again, Jaycee threw open her arms, instantly recognized her, and called Auntie Tina.
Jaycee and her daughters are with her mom and younger sister in a secluded place, reconnecting.
Tina Dugard says for 5 days, she too was with Jaycee, helping her begin to recover from 18 years of captivity, allegedly at the hands of Philip and Nancy Garrido.
Not only have we laughed and cried together, but we've spent time sitting quietly, taking pleasure in each other's company.
The family released these new photographs of Jaycee as a child, but still none showing what she looks like now as a 29-year-old woman.
She'll want to know what happened.
Clinical psychologist Maria Andriga says Jaycee's family will have to be careful not to make a common mistake among relatives of former kidnapping victims.
This idea that it's all over now, that you're in safe hands, and we loved you then, we love you now, let's just pick up life and continue as if it didn't happen.
Andriga recommends the entire family get counseling so that they'll know how to help Jaycee on good days and bad.
So that she doesn't feel like she has to always put on a happy face.
For now, Tina Dugard still has a Barbie doll she'd planned to give to Jaycee before the abduction, and she says Jaycee's mother has once again started combing and braiding her long-lost daughter's hair.
The smile on my sister's face is as wide as the sea. Her oldest daughter is finally home.
And according to the psychologist we spoke with today, among the problems that Jaycee may eventually face is a sleep disorder, anxiety, depression, and that in addition to perhaps lifelong counseling, she may also require medication. Live in the HD Newsroom, David Bienick, KCRA 3 reports.
Yeah, a lot of those post-traumatic stress symptoms. David, thank you.